Fantastic. Tony, thanks for being here. Love the shoes, man. Love the t-shirt.
Thank you.
You are a clown with Ringling Brothers.
That would be me.
Now, tell me a little bit about this. How does one get to be a clown with Ringling Brothers?
Well, there's two ways. They used to have Clown College, which actually closed back in 1997. Back then, over 5,000 applicants each year would try to apply to get into Clown College, to get into the show. But they end up only picking about 64. So back then, the statistics was it was harder to get into Clown College than it was to get into Harvard. But what I did was I went to a Clown College audition they held in New York. It was an open call. So I drove my car all the way to Madison Square Garden, got a hotel there, and then I unicycled there in the morning of.
You unicycled from where exactly to Madison Square Garden?
Right across the street. It's not the car.
I thought you were coming from like Connecticut or New Jersey or something, or through the Lincoln Tunnel. Okay, so you unicycled across the street. This caught their attention.
Yes.
Awesome.
Yeah, and they nicknamed me Uniboy. I think the 5-foot unicycle that I rode at the end sealed the deal, and that's how I got in.
Wow. All right. Now, how many people tried out in New York and actually got in?
In New York, we had about 40 people try out.
Yeah.
At the end, they picked about 7 finalists.
Yeah.
And that was one of 4 auditions in the United States. And I was the only one from that audition that got in.
All right. Now, have you picked your character yet? I mean, do you know what you're kind of going to be doing?
I do.
Oh, can you tell us, or is it a secret?
I don't know if you can see it, the spiky hair.
This is not natural.
No, it's not.
I didn't know.
It's inspired by, I don't know if you've ever seen the Dragon Ball Z cartoons.
Yes, I was thinking of that.
Yeah,
and here it is.
I'm gonna be a karate clown.
Ah, cool. All right, a karate clown. And now, can you show us some clown stuff here today, this morning? Do you have some clown stuff?
I
have your clown nose. But do you have some clown tricks for our 100th episode?
I do. Oh, speaking of your 100th episode, next year, the show I'm gonna be part of, it's called Barnum's Bonundrum. We're celebrating 200 years of Barnum and Bailey.
No,
just actually
kidding.
Barnum, P.T. Barnum, sorry.
Wow. Yeah. Almost. We're almost that long. All right, so what's our first one going to be here?
This is called The Mystery of the Grey Poupon. It's a trick I learned when I was a little kid when I couldn't afford to do magic. Basically, I got a paper bag. The Grey Poupon, aka mustard.
Right.
Goes into the bag.
Yeah.
Snap my fingers and becomes a bottle of ketchup.
No way.
Now watch. Snap it. Becomes the mustard again. Magic mustard. That was the hard part.
Wow. So now show me that again. Maybe we can have the cameras do it in slow motion. So the Grey Poupon goes in. Now it has become ketchup.
A bottle of ketchup.
And now
that becomes the mustard again.
Wow.
No,
I know you're thinking.
See, it's actually empty.
Yeah. That was incredible. Gee, here I was thinking that it was stuck inside there. What I was actually thinking was, it is no surprise to me that you would be the one who was picked to be the clown.
Let's scratch that trick.
Whoa. Pretty good, Tony. Not bad. Not bad. All right. And you taught yourself that when you were like 12.
Yes.
All right. Cool. What has Ringling Brothers taught you anything that you can show us?
They taught me a little bit of miming, but that's about it.
Let's not do miming. That's not good. We'll save that for the radio show. All right, what else do you have for us?
Let's see. I have what's called, I don't know, you've seen clowns, birthday clowns, they do the balloon sculptures.
All right.
Sword swallowing, you've seen that probably.
Yeah.
I've combined the two arts, and I call it balloon sword swallowing.
Balloon sword swallowing here on the 100th episode of Wake Up Worcester. Tony the Clown. Tony, we got 2 minutes, so
okay.
How long does... We got to make sure. All right, now this is great. And this again, now is this something that you showed them in your audition when you were there?
No, this is something I picked up about 2 months ago.
Okay, well, I mean, what did you kind of show them that,
that they
picked you?
I actually did a whole routine of magic. I sneezed out a flower. I made a card castle appear. I pulled a bra out of one of their clowns. And
one of their clowns.
I did.
Maybe. All right. Man, congratulations. By the way, the circus, of course, Ringling Brothers, is here at the DCU Center. It's here on Thursday. It's beginning. As a matter of fact, Monday afternoon, I saw the circus train pull in. How cool was that?
That was
now,
pretty cool.
Listen, I know that you brought John with you from Juggle Worcester. Folks who want to learn how to juggle can go to jugglewooster.com, and John helped you learn to juggle?
Yeah, he's the one who actually taught me how to juggle.
All right, John, come on. We'll bring John up here. Now, you guys are going to juggle. And for the 100th episode, because I think that's all that we had budgeted was for 100 episodes anyway, I will actually stand in the middle while you do this. And I want to thank everybody, make sure that we thank everybody for joining us for these first 100 episodes of Wake Up Worcester. Be sure and tell your friends. John from Juggle Worcester with us. Tony the Clown from Ringling Brothers. Tony, thank you for being here this morning.
Thank you. Well, right before here. We end the show, I just want to say, make sure you catch the pre-show. It's 1 hour before the show. It's free with your ticket. You can get up close and personal with the performers, the animals, and get their autographs and talk to them.
Tony, Ringling Brothers is going to love you.
Ringling.com.
We're ready here on Wake Up Worcester, and thanks again, everybody, for joining us right here on Charter Channel 3.
Just kidding.
Never get up, you know, you know.